Hey everyone, welcome to SFDC Stop, and in this video we are going to talk about design tokens in Lightning Web Components, right? So design tokens are named entities that store visual design attributes. So in other words, I can simply say that these are the named CSS properties that we can use in our Lightning Web Components. There are two types of design tokens that we can use. One is SLDS design tokens and second is custom design tokens, right? So if we talk about SLDS design tokens, these are the design tokens that are available in Salesforce Lightning Design System. And they are globally available. So all the design tokens that are a part of SLDS and they are marked as global, we can use these design tokens in our Lightning Web Components. And there are also some custom design tokens. So custom design tokens can be default tokens. So these are the design tokens that we include in our default tokens bundle. And custom tokens, so these are the design tokens that we include in our custom bundle. So I mean, we can create different design tokens bundles, and one is the default tokens bundle, which should be in your Salesforce org, and other are custom tokens bundle, which are having a custom name, right? So we'll see all this in detail as we move further. And there's also a concept that you can use custom tokens directly in your applications, so we'll see about that as well. Okay, so let's begin our demo so that we can understand this in detail, that what are design tokens and how we can use them in our application. So what I have done till now, I have created a very simple Lightning application which is calling my tokens demo Lightning Web Component. And this Lightning Web Component is a very simple empty Lightning Web Component. And inside this component, I am going to define a div. And inside this div, I can simply say that this is my, or I can say this is the main div, right? And I want to specify some CSS property using design tokens, right? So for that, I'm going to give it a class, and the class name is main. Now let's define a CSS file. So I can simply say tokens demo.css, and I can specify a main class in which I can specify some properties. So let's say I want to have a background color of blue. So I can simply say that background is blue. And I want to specify a text color of white, right? So I can simply say that text color is white. So what I have done till now, I have specified, I have created a div which is having a class as main. And inside my CSS file, I have defined my main class in which I say that background color should be blue and text color should be white, right? So this is very simple demo of how you specify CSS in your application, right? So let's see how it is working, or let's see our application first of all. So this is our application. Let me refresh it once. And here you can see that it is having a background color of blue and it is having a text color of white, right? So this is how, I mean, we can define our custom CSS in our Lightning Web Components. Now let's see how we can use design tokens in our Lightning Web Components. So as I specified before, that there are two types of design tokens that we can use. One is SLDS design token and second is custom design token. So let's talk about SLDS design tokens first. So SLDS design tokens are the design tokens which are specified in Lightning Design System, right? So these are the tokens which are available here in Lightning Design System. So you can simply go to this particular URL, lightningdesignsystem.com/design-tokens, and you will see all the design tokens that are having a global access. So all these design tokens that are having a global access, these tokens you can use in your Lightning Web Components. So for example, let's say I want to have a blue background color. So I can simply pick this particular design token. Let's go to background color section first of all, and I can pick any of the design token which is having a global access. So let's say I want to pick this particular color, right? So this particular color is having a global access. It is under the background color, and I can use this particular design token which is having a name as color-background-invert, right? So what I can do, I can simply copy this. I can go to my Lightning Web Component CSS file, and I can say that my background color is nothing but so it should be under var, and I can specify -lwc -my design token name. So my design token name is nothing but color-background-invert. And in case you are using your design tokens in LWC, you need to specify those token name in camel case. So instead of using color-background-inverse, I need to specify it in camel case. So I can simply do it like this, color background. And I can remove the hyphen from here, and I can keep I capital, right? So this is how I can define the design token in camel case, and that's it, okay? So my background is defined, and I want to have my text color as white, right? So let's have a look at some text color as well, which are globally available. So I want to have some text color that are globally available, right? So let's see. Okay, so this is the text color I think that we can use, and it is matching with my background color as well. and it is also globally available, right? So I can simply use this particular design token, which is named as color-text-inverse. So I'm going to copy this, and inside my Lightning Web Component, I can specify that color should be var. So var is basically a function which is used to specify, or I can say use a CSS variable, right? So inside this var, I can specify --lwc. So this LWC basically tells us that we are using a design token from the Lightning design system. And after the hyphen, I can specify the design token name. And this design token name should be in camel case. So I can say that it should be color text and then inverse. Okay. And that's it. So my source is pushed and I can refresh this page now. And here you can see, now I'm having a background color by using the design token that I specified, which is color background inverse. And I'm also having a text color, which is using my design token, which is color text inverse, right? So it is basically the same design as I am able to see here, right? Okay, so this is how, I mean, we can use our SLDS design tokens. The only thing that you need to take care of is that the design token should have a global access. In case you are not having a global access, you won't be able to use those design tokens in your Lightning Web Component. So you can choose any of the CSS property. It is not only about colors. You can choose a font size as well, a font family as well. But you just need to take care of that. Those design tokens should have a global access, right? So that's all about the SLDS design token, or I can simply say that global SLDS design tokens, right? Now let's have a look at what are custom design tokens. So custom design tokens are tokens that we define in our default tokens bundle. So whenever you are creating a new token bundle in your Salesforce org, you need to name it as default tokens. This is a requirement by Salesforce that the first token bundle that you define in your Salesforce application should have a name as default tokens, right? And you cannot create a tokens bundle from VS Code as of now. I checked the GitHub issue for this as well. So creating a token is not available right now in VS Code. For example, if you go to command palette and you search for tokens, so you cannot create a token using the VS Code. So what are we going to do? We are going to use the developer console, and I can go to simply file new and then Lightning tokens. And here I can say that my token bundle name is default tokens, right? So it should be default tokens. Okay. Yeah, default tokens. Okay. And I can give a description if required, although I'm not going to give a description here, and I'm going to submit this. So this is the default token bundle that is created. It is having a aura colon tokens tag, and inside this tokens bundle, I can specify a number of tokens, which are nothing but my named CSS properties. So let's say I want to change my application now. I don't want to have these tokens, but I want to use some different tokens, right? So for example, let's say I'm going to define another div here. So this is my second div below this. Okay. And it is going to have a class name as main one. And I can say that this is the main one div. Okay. And inside this main one property, I'm going to use my custom tokens. So main one. And inside this, I'm going to use custom tokens, right? Okay, so let's move back to our design tokens. And inside this design tokens bundle, I can specify a number of design tokens. So for example, I'm specifying a design token using the aura token tag. And I can say that the name of my design token is nothing but, let's say my text color, okay? And the value of this text color is nothing but, let's say yellow, okay? And I can also specify another aura token for the background color here. So aura token, and the name for this token is nothing but my background color. Okay. And the value of this token is nothing but, let's say, what can we have? We can have a black color as background. Okay. And that's it. You can also specify hex code here. So for example, you want to use a black color. So you can specify hash and then some hex code like 12 12 12 or something, right? So mainly it is 000, but we can use black here because it is a very common color. Okay. So these are the default, inside the default tokens bundle, I have defined two design tokens. One is my text color and second is my background color. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use these design tokens inside my main one div. Let's first of all preview our application once. So I'm going to refresh this page. And here you can see, this is the main div. Let me just zoom it. And this is the main one div, right? And for the main one div, I want to use a background color and a text color as well. So I can simply specify background is nothing but again a var, and then I can specify my custom design token. So my custom design token is having a name as my text color and my background color, right? So I can specify here that var will be hyphen hyphen c hyphen my background color, background color, okay. And simply for text color, I can say that it should be var, and inside this var I can say hyphen hyphen c hyphen my text color, okay. And that's it. So whenever you are specifying a design token which is from SLDS library, you need to use it as like this, which is nothing but LWC, I mean hyphen hyphen LWC and then hyphen and then your design token name. And in case you are using a design token from your own custom tokens bundle, you can specify it like this, hyphen hyphen c hyphen my text color or my background color or whatever color, I mean whatever name of design token that you have specified, okay. Let's refresh this page and let's see what is the difference. Okay, so now you can see this particular div is going to have a color as black color, which is the background color, and it is also having a text color as yellow color, right? So I can simply say that I have used my default tokens, or I can say my tokens from the default tokens bundle inside my Lightning Web component, and I have specified these tokens in my LWC component CSS file, right? Okay. So we have used the SLDS tokens and we have used the custom tokens as well. Now let's have a look at the custom tokens bundle, because right now we have used tokens from our default tokens bundle. Now let's see how we can use our tokens from our custom tokens bundle. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to define two tokens bundle. So let's define another tokens bundle, and it can have a name as text color tokens. Okay. And inside this text color tokens, I can simply define one property. So I can pick up my text color property from here and I can save my text color property in here. Okay. So now what I have done, I have defined my text color design token in my text color tokens bundle instead of default tokens bundle. Okay. First of all, let's refresh our app and let's see what is the difference. Okay, so as you can see here now that the yellow color is no more here, but it is showing me some default color, which is the default text color whenever I'm creating a Lightning application, right? So yellow color is no more here, but I have defined it in my text color tokens bundle, right? So why this color is not coming? Because this color is not a part of default tokens bundle. So whatever property or whatever aura token that you define in your default tokens bundle, that is readily accessible by your Lightning Web components. But in case you are specifying a property in some other tokens bundle apart from the default tokens bundle, those property wouldn't be really accessible, or I can say readily accessible by your Lightning Web components. So how you can get these properties accessible by your Lightning Web components? The only way to do that is to import these. And how can we import these? I can simply say that my default tokens bundle will extend a new tokens bundle, which is nothing but C colon text color tokens. Okay. So if I say that my default tokens bundle is extending my text color tokens bundle, in that way I can import all the tokens that are defined in my text color tokens bundle in my default tokens bundle. And once I have imported those tokens, that are readily useful in my Lightning Web components, right? So let's refresh this page and let's see what happens now. And now you can see my yellow color is back, right? Similarly, I can specify a number of tokens bundle. So for example, let's say I want to specify a tokens bundle for my background color as well. So what I can do, I can go to file and I can go to my Lightning tokens, and I can say that my tokens bundle name is background color tokens, right? And I can submit this. Now inside my background color tokens bundle, I can pick this property or I can pick this token from here, and I can specify it in my background color tokens bundle. Okay. Now if you are thinking that how will I import this background color tokens bundle into my default tokens bundle, now this is the question, right? Because if I refresh this application, I won't be having my background color as black, because this is now defined in some other tokens bundle that I have to import in my default tokens if I want to use it, right? So as you can see, my background color is no more there because it is defined in this particular tokens bundle and I haven't imported it in my default tokens bundle. So if you are thinking that you can specify it like this, like a comma and then C colon background color tokens. So this is not the way. This cannot be done. You cannot specify a number of tokens comma separated, or you cannot extend the number of tokens comma separated in your default tokens bundle. But what you can do, you can create a hierarchy. So for example, this default tokens bundle is extending text color tokens, right? And I can say that my text color tokens bundle is extending my background color tokens, right? So if I do it like this, in this way I can use I'm importing my background color tokens in my text color tokens, and I'm importing my text color tokens in my default tokens. So ultimately I'm importing all the tokens that are defined in my Salesforce org into my default tokens bundle, and this default tokens bundle is readily accessible to Lightning Web Components. So I can simply refresh this page again, and here you can see that all the tokens that I have defined, whether it is a background color token or a text color token, they are a part of my default tokens bundle now, and I can use it in my Lightning Web Components, right? So this was about custom tokens, that how you can define custom tokens and how you can use them in your default tokens, or I can say in your Lightning Web Components. The only prerequisite is that you should have a default tokens bundle, and that should extend other tokens, and then other tokens can extend other tokens as well, and you can use all the tokens that you have defined in your CSS. So you just need to give a name and a value, and you can simply specify to your custom tokens by using --c --my design token name. Okay, so there is one exception that is particularly available in applications, right? So if you are creating a Lightning application like this particular application, right? So in that case, you can use multiple tokens without defining those tokens or importing those tokens in your default tokens bundle. So let's see that as well. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this import in my default tokens bundle, and I'm going to remove this import in my text color tokens bundle as well. Okay, so I have removed all the imports, and now my default tokens bundle is empty, and I have my text color tokens bundle and I have my background color tokens bundle as well. So if I just refresh this application, I should be able to see no more color as background color and yellow color as this, right? So as you can see here, yellow color is also gone and my background black color is also gone, right? Now I have one more property, that in case I'm creating a Lightning application, I can specify a number of tokens in my Lightning application directly instead of using it in default tokens. So as I'm calling my Lightning component inside this application, so I can specify that whichever tokens that my application is using. So I can simply say that I'm using a number of tokens, and those tokens are nothing but C colon text color tokens and comma C colon background color tokens. Okay, and this is only available in case of Lightning application. So in case you are creating a Lightning application, you can specify that a number of tokens I'm using. So this is the first token that I'm using, which is nothing but text color tokens, and this is the second token that I'm using, which is nothing but background color tokens. And it doesn't matter whether you have imported those tokens in your default tokens or not, those tokens will be visible in all the components that are part of your Lightning application. So if I just update this application preview, and you can see here that inside my application, I'm able to use my design tokens, which is having a background color as black and the text color as yellow, right? So either you can specify, I mean, there are two ways. Either you can import all your tokens inside your default tokens by creating a hierarchy, so that those tokens will be available to all the Lightning components in your org, irrespective of what application they are a part of. Or in case you want to use some tokens specific to your application, you can specify those tokens as here I have specified by using the tokens attribute. And you can use those tokens inside all the Lightning components that are a part of your Lightning application, right? So this is how, I mean, you can use your design tokens, or I can say you can use your custom design tokens, right? So I hope this tutorial is clear to everyone, and let me know your feedback in the comments down below. And I'll see you in the next video, where we'll talk about CSS, how you can define custom style sheets in your Lightning Web Components, and how you can share CSS among different Lightning Web Components, right? So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, have a good day. Bye-bye.